All right, now we're going to look at how we can use that to do more examples of rational expressions. So now here we are not given factored form, so you're going to have to rewrite that. So do a my eyes only column so that you can work on questions like that. So we have x squared plus 4x. What is the greatest common factor across here, which is the x? And so times x plus 4. And then here's x plus 4, so let's rewrite it. So this x squared plus 4x in factored form was x times x plus 4. This one already is x plus 4. Now it's in the factored form. So do you remember what to do? To make common denominator, you have to look at least common multiple. All right, so this one already has everything we need. This one is going to need an x on top and bottom. All right, so once you have that, then finish it off. X times x is x squared. So look at what's happening here. We had to use the concept of least common multiple to make a common denominator, but we also had to use greatest common factor here to factor this. So both quantities in the same problem. Just trying to show you how sometimes, as we learn more and more material, problems can be using all of those concepts in one problem. All right, try that on your own. I'll give you a few moments. It's not written in the factored form, so you have to do the work here. So find the greatest common factor of x times x minus 1 and 5 times x minus 1. So that would be x minus 1. So we can rewrite this as x minus 1 times x plus 5. What about this? We can write that as x plus 5 times 2 minus x because x plus 5 is the greatest common factor we can pull out. Now that we have the factored form of both the denominators, let's rewrite it. Now we have to find what? We have to make a common denominator across here, which means we have to find least common multiple. So let's do that. So least common multiple of x minus 1 and x plus 5. X plus 5 and 2 minus x. So we're going to have x minus 1, x plus 5, 2 minus x. So let's see what we have here. X minus 1 is there, x plus 5 is there. We're missing 2 minus x's. What are we missing here? We're missing x minus 1's. Okay, now what? Now you know what to do. Term by term multiplication using distributive property and then add like terms. Once you are at this stage, then you know what to do because we've done it now many, many times. See if you understand why that is. So let's see. 2 times 2 is 4. 2 times negative x is negative 2x. Negative 4x times 2 is negative 8x. Negative 4x times negative x is positive 4x squared. X times x is x squared. X times negative 1 is negative x. 1 times x is plus x. 1 times negative 1 is negative 1. Everybody understand how we got all these terms? All right, simplify this now, add like terms. Let's see what we have here. 4 is this 4. Negative 2x minus 8x is going to be negative 10x. And 4x squared is going to be 4x squared. This minus sign belongs to all of the stuff that's inside here. Inside here, what do we have? We have x squared, negative x plus x, that will just give you 0, and negative 1. And that negative belongs to everything inside, so negative of x squared will give me negative x squared. Negative 1 will give me positive 1. Remember, this middle term just added up to 0, so there's nothing there. Now add like terms. So 4 plus 1 will give me 5, negative 10x will be negative 10x. 4x squared minus x squared will give me 3x squared, and then that's your final answer. So again, if you're stuck on any of these steps, go back and review. Watch it again and again until you really get it. So attempt the next few on your own in video log questions.